It is estimated that Africa's population will increase by 115% by the year 2050. This means 100% food increase will be needed to feed the population. While worldwide hunger decreased by 132 million in the last 20 years, the hunger increased by 64 million in Africa because the continent faces threats of climate change and farming-related land resource degradations. But the good news is that it is easier to double yields in Africa, for instance, from 1.2 to 2.4 tons per hectare. A 1% increase in cereal yields can lift 2 million people out of poverty, given that Africa has 60% of the global total uncultivated cropland, and Africa has 4 of the world's top 10 fastest-growing economies. The need for sustainable intensification in sub-Saharan Africa is widely recognized. Farm power in sub-Saharan Africa countries is declining due to the collapse of most tractor hire schemes, the decline in number of drought animals, and the decline in human labor. Sustainable intensification in sub-Saharan Africa will require an improvement of farm power balance through increased power supply and improved access to mechanization and reduced power demand via energy-saving technologies such as conservation agriculture. Dr. Gichuki Mushiri has been a farmer since 1973, and he understands very well the need for conservation agriculture.
Conventional tillage or conventional farming has one great disadvantage, and that is the soil is exposed to high temperature, and because of that the level of organic matter is reduced substantially. So once that happens, that affects the soil fertility. In other words, soil organic matter management in conventional tillage under hot climate is not good.
One of the interventions Fakasi is using is to evaluate and demonstrate two-wheel tractor-based technologies to support conservation agriculture systems. The evaluations and demos are done through the concept of service provision. Bungoma County is one of the counties where Fakasi is implementing the use of two-wheel tractors.
Mimi mwenyewe ni makanika wa ikitu, huwa ninaifungua, inaweka chini engine, naifunga tena, na ninaendelea na safari, kwa sababu nimeisoea ni kama paisikeli tu.
Fakasi has set up demonstration plots where the use of two-wheel tractor as a source of farm power is used on small farm sizes.
Huwa tunatumia two-wheel tractor, natumia tunakuwa tunaspray kwanza, tukimaliza, tunapima plot. Na hapa tuko na plot 18. Huwa tunatumia planda moja, napanda plot moja hapa, plot ingine hapo katikati, plot ingine kwa mwisho. Tukianza analysis, huwa tunaandika kila plot iko na mimea ngapi, alafu tunachukua tada, tujue planda gani imepanda mzuri, planda gani imepanda mbaya.
We have got the single hole fritterary planter planting maize. This planter is quite effective. As you can see, it have got a quarter down here, which is purposely meant for cutting the trash, because in conservation agriculture we emphasize on soil cover mostly. Followed by a tine, which can open. It's a very hard tine, high carbon tine, which cannot break or bend easily. It is meant for opening the ground. The following is the fertilizer pipe, which pours the fertilizer after the tine has opened. and then followed by the seed pipe and followed with a covering wheel or the rotating wheel which drives the shaft to drive the whole system.
Nafanya ukulima kwa shamba, panda mahindi, maua. Na yote hii nimefanya nikitumia ng'ombe ya kufuta na chembe. Lakini hivi karibuni niliwahi kuomba kuhaya two wheel farm tractor ambaye nimetumia once kwa shamba langu ile ambayo niko na ekari mbili na robo. Lakini niliona nikitumia hiyo farm wheel tractor, two wheel tractor, karama yake inakuwa ndogo.
Kwa kila mkulima namtumia kwa miaka tatu kwa hiyo plot yake. Sasa paka anze na mafuno yake ya kwanza, ya pili, ya tatu. Alafu aone tofauti iko namna gani.
On the whatever. Yeah, you see, you cannot train what you are not. This wheat was planted by a two-wheel tractor. Yeah. The wrong grain. Direct seeding using two row fitareri. Yeah. And also spray. I used the two-wheel tractor to spray. It works very well. The coverage, the time taken is very minimal. So when we talk about the economical issues, it is good. It can some business it can do very well, like a trailer, like a spray, like a planting. And that much land where the, my skidding is not there, you do very well. Because one day you can plant at least, like maize, we plant 10 acres in a day. Beans, you can plant 5 acres comfortably. So what I can say is that mechanization is the way. Many farmers, somehow, in some cases, they prefer two-wheel tractor than the four-wheel tractor. Like in the case of spraying, remember this one, I've got less damage to the crop compared to the four-wheel tractor. Again, consider a luggage of maybe 1 ton. You can't go for a four-wheel tractor to carry for you 10 bags of cement, 1 ton of sand, 1 ton of ballast, this maize, 5-10 bags. Remember, you cannot go for a four-wheel tractor to spray 1 acre. But this one, we spray as little as half an acre. So it becomes very ideal for small-scale farmers. What I can say should be improved for this tractor is traction. The engine power is sufficient, but the traction system, the wheeling system, it needs to be a bit broader and bigger. Being broader, it will offer bigger service area for traction. Again, when they are big enough, you can even put water in them to add weight.
African Conservation Tillage Network Act is a pan-African not-for-profit organization that promotes conservation agriculture through different stakeholders. The Executive Secretary for ACT, Engineer Saidi Mkomwa, says mechanization in Africa has delayed.
The time is over. We should have mechanized long, long ago. Africa has had a lot of farm mechanization programs, the majority of which did not go well, or to be straightforward, they failed. One of the main reasons is because the level of mechanization, or rather the machinery which was introduced, did not match the farm sizes. We are talking of 100 horsepower tractors meant for farmers with 100 acres and above, when the average farm sizes in Africa are 1 hectare or even less, which means these machines cannot operate efficiently in the smallholder farms that we have. We need appropriate, more suitable machines. And we think the two-wheel tractors are more appropriate, quite suitable, as they have proved to be. All what we need is the right policy environment, the right business sector support for these farmers to adopt and transform their farming a mechanized system.
The Kenya Network for Dissemination of Agricultural Technologies, KENDAT, empowers smallholder farmers to sustainably improve their livelihoods through innovative access to information technology, means and market. Kendat Chief Executive Officer Dr. Pascal Kaumbudo says the two-wheel farm tractor is good timing for a smallholder farmer.
The two-wheel tractors have a new chance, a new opportunity in the country because of the low power requirement that they have. Now that they need to only open a small slot on the ground, put in the fertilizer and seed. So really, also looking at the mechanization in the sense of rural transport, the motorbikes that have made rural industry thrive in terms of being able to fix your machine wherever you are, I think this has been a great opportunity for Kasi in this country. It's the right mechanization at the right time.
By this system, it is cutting the production cost by 65 to 70% every year or every season. Because when you plow, you do harrowing, you do ridges, you plant with the manually, then at the end of the day your profit is gone. But on conservation agriculture using mechanization, you save time, energy and finances.
To overcome some of the challenges faced in the use of two-wheel tractor by smallholder farmers, local Juakali artisans like Mzee Patrick Nyongesa have come up with innovations to provide solutions in transportation using the walking tractor.
Upande wa kwetu huko tunalimia ng'ombe. Sasa nimeona naye ng'ombe yenyewe mashamba naye imekuwa kidogo. Hasa vile imekuwa kidogo, ndio nimeona sasa sababu hakuna mali ya kuchunga ng'ombe ile ya kulima, ndio nikatengeneza hii mashine. Hiyo tractor ya mikuu mbili ni mzuri sababu inashika nafasi kidogo na tena mafuta yake nakula kidogo. Lakini wakati unalima nayo, ukilima nayo shamba kama eka moja, hii makono hii unaumia sana sababu force ya kupenduka hiyo mikuu mbili. Ndio niliona baada ya mikuu mbili nifanye hii mikuu nne. Hasa mikuu nne inakuwa rahisi. Hata mtoto mtoko kama huyu anakaa tu anaendesha.